Hello guys, in this video we are going to discuss about selecting a specific column from the Excel sheet. Okay, so this is one of the best ways to select in this we are going to discuss about one of the best ways to select a specific column from an Excel sheet. Okay, so yeah, let's go. You can see this is my input. It's having last name, address and pin code. So I'll bring this pin code values, and I'll try to experiment with a different combination. Then I'll try to bring everything from last name, address and pin code, everything. Okay, so let's go to our workflow. Yeah, so first thing we need is, I've taken one sequence here, we need is Excel application scope, and show that Excel sheet. This is my Excel sheet. Okay, then just type Excel here. You can see so many things are there. In this, our thing is we are reading a column, right? So just select read column. Okay, then it will ask for what is the sheet name and what is the column that you want to read. What is it? It is nothing but a range. It will read that range. Okay, so our sheet name is sheet 1 and our range is, so they have, by default they have given is A1. Okay, so this is A1. Okay, so it is pointing to first column. What I will give is, we are reading pin code, right? So I'll give C1. Okay, so sheet is correct only, and range is C1. And if you see here, it is of result. We have to declare that result. Let me give it as pin. Okay, now go here in variable section and see what is the pin. Increase the scope to the old sequence. Okay, only it is there as of now. And you can see this one. This is a enumerable type of string object type here. Okay, then what we'll do is let me loop the each value to see how the data is coming. For each loop, then we'll see what we can do. Yeah, it's not coming, right? Because this is, now you got right scope to the sequence. Then you save it. Then you have item. And try to print here to see how the data is coming. For your requirement, you can, as per your business requirement, you can do many things with that. Message box. Item dot to string. Okay, then let me execute this. Now you can see pin code first column came 506 102 206 205 113 112 113 105. This is one of the best ways. I'll suggest is this is one of the best ways to select a column, because you are saving into an enumerable type and you just doing loop through it. Okay, now what will we do is, we got the first column pin code, right? We got this one, right? This value. So what will I do is, since I started from C1, it is taken that one. What I'll do is, I'll start from C2, then we'll see how the output is coming. So this is C2. Now execute it. 506 102 206 205 113 105 105. give me a second. Yeah, so now I'm starting from C2. We have seen right how the data is coming. I think that is clear. So let me execute it one more time. Now you can see we got it from 506. Then that is clear now. Now what I'll do is C2, I'll change the range to C5. Okay. So let's see how we can, what is output we are getting. Okay. So ideally you should start from C2, but when you give that range between those two, it will only check the end condition here. It is only checking that end condition. So pin code 506, this is 1, 2, 3, 2064, 2055, that's it. So when you are giving this range condition, it is taking only the end condition. It is starting from the beginning, now it is taking from the end condition. Okay, the similar way you can select any specific column like that. If you want to select this B column, this is B1, like that. Okay, first one is A1. If you want to select something here, just get, fill the input file and select that one. Okay, as per your business need. Now what I'll do is, instead of this one, I'll give A1/C5 and see how the output is coming. Okay, now if you see, A1 is last name, C5 is our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, our 205. Okay, so you can see here last name, address, pin code X, CD 506, Y, V 102, Z, QA 206. After this, now observe, 205 we are getting, that's it. Now why we got only 205, why haven't we got anything here? Because these are the empty values, simple. Now what I'll do is, let me fill with some other value. Now let me execute it and see how the data will be coming. Last name, address, pin code, X, CD 506, Y, WQ102, Z, QA 206, SADF 205, that's it. Now you understood it. So it is not allowing the empty values. That's I want to point out here. And you can experiment with the different values, different selection parameters with this. And if you have any doubt, please mention in a comment section. And if you have some other doubts, if you want me to explain something else, you can always ping in the comment section or ping to my WhatsApp group or my Facebook page. I'll always help you out. Thank you.